Distanza spinarum. How many centimeters?
25 to 27.
27. Between crista iliaca.
Distanza crista 28 to 29.
And between greater trochanters.
Distanza 31 to 32.
Okay. Now, space between promontorium and middle part of pubic symphysis.
Conjugata vera.
How many centimeters?
11 centimeters.
How we can found this distance?
Two ways.
First is
conjugata diagonale.
First is conjugata externa, that is space between pubic symphysis and
the tip of the spinous process of the fifth lumbar.
Yes, below of the fifth lumbar process, fifth lumbar vertebra, yes, spinal process of fifth lumbar vertebra. That is conjugata externa, how many centimeters?
20 to 21, 22.
And we minus 10 or 11 centimeters and found conjugata vera. And more correct, that is conjugata diagonalis, space between inferior part of pubic symphysis and promontorium. And we minus 1.5 centimeters and found conjugata vera. And transverse distance of pelvic inlet, we subdivide distance crestarum into two. Space between apex of coccyx and lower part of pubic symphysis, that is direct size of pubic outlet, that is the same 11 centimeters, and transverse size of pelvic outlet
9.5,
and we plus 1.5 and the receive 11 centimeters. Okay. Next time you will prepare knee joint and articulation between bones of the leg. Knee joint. Knee joint, that is simple compound joint.
Compound
because it consists of how many bones? Three bones: femur, tibia, and patella. Fibula not participate in knee joint. Fibula is here, and head of the fibula not participate in knee joint. But patella, that is third bone. That is why it is compound. Next. What is the shape of this joint? That is these two condyles, and here it is two condyles. They join together. That is why it is condyloid joint. Compound, condyloid. Then inside of this joint we have a meniscus, that is cartilage which has, give me a pen please. This cartilage has triangular shape. Peripheral part of this cartilage is broad, and central part is narrow. And that is, here it is condyles of femur. Here it is condyles of tibia, and here it is meniscus lateralis, and here it is meniscus medialis. And these two meniscus separates cavities of this joint into two halves, above of meniscus and below of them. That is why here it is capsule, and peripheral part of meniscus fused with the capsule, and the central part, it is free border inside of knee joint. That is why this joint is complex, because it has meniscus which separates joint into two halves. And again, it is compound because consists of three bones. It is condyloid, that is a shape of articular surfaces. It is biaxial, and it is complex joint. axis of movement, in frontal axis, what is the movement in frontal flexion and extension, and in vertical axis is possible pronation and supination. Yes, right. Two axes of movement. Now, ligaments. Very difficult to explain ligaments without model. First of all, we have intra-articular ligaments, the same like in hip joint. They are ligamentum cruciatum genus. Ligamentum cruciatum anterior and posterior. Anterior ligaments start from inner surface of lateral condyle of femur and goes to area intercondylaris anterior. And posterior ligament. Posterior ligament start from inner surface of medial condyle and goes to area intercondylaris posterior. Here it is place of attachment of anterior ligament, ligamentum cruciatum anterior, and here it is place of attachment of ligamentum cruciatum posterior. And one ligament is between both meniscus. Here it is meniscus medialis, here it is meniscus lateralis, and in front of them, between them, we have transverse ligament of the knee joint, ligamentum transversum genus. That is why three intra-articular ligaments, ligamentum cruciatum anterior, posterior, and ligamentum transversum genus. All other ligaments are extra-articular. And here it is, we have ligamentum collaterale tibiale, start from medial epicondyle and goes to medial condyle of tibia. Then here it is ligamentum collaterale fibulare, start from lateral epicondyle and goes to the head of fibula, ligamentum collaterale fibulare. Anteriorly, between apex of patella and tuberositas tibia, we have ligamentum patella. Then posteriorly we have ligamentum popliteum obliquum, oblique ligament, start from medial epicondyle of femur and attached to condyle of tibia, ligamentum popliteum obliquum, and ligamentum popliteum arcuatum, it's goes from previous ligament and attached to the head of fibula, ligamentum popliteum arcuatum. And last ligament, that is retinacula patella, this ligament start from tendon of quadriceps and goes to patella, from the region of patella, goes horizontally to both epicondyles of femur, and vertical fibers goes to both condyles of tibia, retinacula patella. They are ligaments in knee joint. And last moment, that is bursa. Do you know what is a bursa? Bursa, that is synovial membrane makes a sac which is present in the region of large bones and large muscles. And they decrease friction between muscles and bones. A knee joint, that is largest joint in human body, and a lot of bursa surround knee joint. One bursa is above of this joint. This bursa is, it is quadriceps muscle, and between quadriceps and femur we have bursa suprapatellaris. Bursa suprapatellaris, it is above of patella. Another bursa below of patella, in place where ligamentum patella attached to tuberositas tibia, below, between ligamentum patella and tibia. Here it is, we have bursa infrapatellaris profunda. Deep bursa below of patella, bursa infrapatellaris profunda. and three bursa in front of patella. Look here, that is patella. Here it is skin, then here it is fascia, fascia, and here it is tendon of quadriceps. And in front of patella we have three bursa. One bursa is below of skin, here it is. And this bursa has name bursa subcutanea prepatellaris. Subcutanea, below of skin. Prepatellaris, in front of patella. Another bursa is below of fascia, here it is. Bursa subfascialis prepatellaris. And last bursa, between tendon of muscle and patella, here it is, bursa subtendinea prepatellaris. Three bursa, below of skin, below of fascia, and below of tendon. Bursa subcutanea prepatellaris, subfascialis, and subtendinea prepatellaris. One bursa above, bursa suprapatellaris, one bursa below, bursa infrapatellaris profunda, and three bursa in front of patella. Five bursa necessary to know. That is knee joint. Next joint, that is joint between head of the fibula and tibia. Here it is, articulatio tibia fibularis. This joint is simple, two bones, plain, and tight joint. There is no movements in this joint, and that is why we will not describe movements, only classification. Simple, plain, and tight joint, amphiarthrosis, and two ligaments, ligamentum capitis fibulae anterior and ligamentum capitis fibulae posterior, in front and behind. Then, two bones of the leg, fibula and tibia, joined together with the help of membrane. What is the name of this membrane? Interossa cruris. In forearm was membrana interossa antebrachii. Here it is membrana interossa cruris. And last type of articulation between fibula and tibia. Here it is incisura fibularis, and here it is malleolus lateralis. Here it is, we have syndesmosis. Syndesmosis tibiofibularis. And this syndesmosis has two types of ligaments. Ligamentum tibiofibularis anterior and ligamentum tibiofibularis posterior. That is all. Ankle joint, not necessary. Next time we will speak about ankle joint and joints of the foot. Only knee joint and articulation between bones of the leg. Here it is proximally articulatio tibia fibularis, distally syndesmosis and membrane. Today that is all. Have you got any questions? That is all.